Hey everybody, welcome back. So glad you're here. As you can see, we are back with another version of Over the Hills and Far Away. When I played the Nightwish version, I totally thought that that sounded familiar, the name of the song. I don't think this is a Gary Moore original either. I think he's doing a cover of it, but I do want to hear his version of it, because a lot of people are talking about it after I did that Nightwish version. So let's check out Gary Moore's version and see how it compares. Kind of cool. Kind of interested in seeing how it goes here. Let's check it out. Cool. That was really good. I don't know a lot about Gary Moore. Over the years, I've heard a few songs and I know a little bit of his history, but I'm not real familiar with a lot of the music that he's done. Although I do believe this was also much older, I think probably like kind of a folk song. But nice rendition of it. He's a great guitar player too, from what I remember about him. Definitely had some stints in some pretty big bands as well. I just can't remember exactly all the history of Gary Moore. I want to say like Thin Lizzy and Deep Purple, but I could be wrong. But that's kind of what's coming to mind for some reason, in the deep recesses of the cobwebs back there. It's hard to make my way through because they're so thick, it's a lot of cobwebs, but I liked it. Pretty cool. I was just curious because people started saying, oh, this is, a Gary Moore song after I did the Nightwish song. And I thought, oh, well, I should check that out too. And so I did. And then, of course, other people said, well, that's not actually a Gary Moore song. And the story continues. So I don't know. Maybe if I can find a recording of the 17th century version, I'll play that too. I'm sure there's probably renditions of it, more traditional, without the distortion and whatnot. But nevertheless, I enjoyed that song. It was pretty good. The video was kind of interesting. I was kind of watching it, but I was really listening to the song mostly. Not sure how that ended, where looks like the relationship continued somehow, and I don't know if they're. If somehow she broke him out, or they got him broken out of the jail, and they had a kid child together, or exactly what was going on there. I don't know what the significance of that tattoo was either. Maybe he was in some kind of brotherhood, and the brotherhood helped him escape a life of prison. Anyways, that was pretty good, and I always like doing stuff like that. Where I can compare. Songs and musicians, and not compare them, but just kind of put them next to each other and just enjoy them together. Not like a competition, but just entertainment, I guess. So, and I was entertained. I hope you were entertained as well. Were you entertained? Do I entertain you? All right, guys. I think I'm out of control. All right. Thank you guys all very, very much. I sure do enjoy listening to music with you guys and hearing all your responses and your comments. Thank you so much for that. And so I'll see you down in the comments. Don't forget to check out my Patreon and other ways to help out the channel. I mentioned it at the end because, I don't make money doing this. It's all, all the copyright stuff goes to the people that own the music, and that's perfectly fine. But if I can get to the point where, some money starts trickling my way and I can spend less time at work and more time doing this, then all the better. Be a dream, wouldn't it? Just a dream. All right. So hit that subscribe button and let's keep this party going. Talk to you guys later. See you in the comments. Bye-bye.